Hi, I'm John Walker, Field Systems Coordinator for Roof Extender. Today we're completing single ply detail, TPO SI2. This detail is designed to seal cuts and punctures using roof extender number 981 silicone roof patch, fleece top repair tape, and a reinforcing membrane. The first and most important consideration when working on a roof is safety. Always follow OSHA and local regulatory requirements when climbing ladders and working on roofs. Be sure to use all appropriate protection equipment as required. Another important item in planning your work is weather. Weather can affect the safety, installation, curing, and ultimate performance of the products being used. Roof Extender Detail TPO SI2 uses silicone-based products and requires the following weather conditions and application rates for proper installation. For best results, apply when air and surface temperatures are 40 degrees Fahrenheit and rising. Apply at a rate of 12.5 square feet per gallon. Skins over in 1 to 2 hours and fully cures in 24 to 36 hours at 70 degrees Fahrenheit and 50% relative humidity. Roof extender number 981 can tolerate rain within 15 to 30 minutes after application. Note, lower humidity, thicker films, poor airflow, and lower temperatures will increase dry times. Again, always check forecasts and monitor weather conditions to ensure you stay within appropriate application guidelines. The last item of planning before starting work is to secure the tools and materials required for the detail. In this case, you will need the following items: gloves, safety glasses, a pair of scissors or utility knife and cutting board, a chip brush or round nose trowel, roof extender 981 silicone roof sealant, fleece back repair tape, a hand roller, and 483 polyester reinforcing fabric.
Now for the fun part, time to get hands-on.
As you can see, we are looking at a field puncture on a TPO membrane that needs to be made 100% watertight. Welded seams or field damage account for the larger portion of leaks on TPO roofs, so it is extremely important to properly seal and reinforce these locations in the proper manner. On this detail, we will be using a 5-course method. Always ensure surface area is clean and properly prepared when performing standalone maintenance repairs. For TPO, a light pressure washing or scrubbing may be required. If primer is required, use a roller or chip brush to prime the area to be repaired using roof extender number 396 single ply primer at a rate of 1/4 gallon per 100 square feet. If you are unsure if a primer is needed, you should complete a pull test. Ensure that the primer has fully cured before applying the fleece top repair tape in the next step. Roll out and cut fleece back repair tape along the area to be repaired, extending a minimum of 3 inches past the repair on each end. Starting at one end, remove the release liner from the repair tape and apply over the cut or puncture in the membrane. Make sure to split the tape equally on each side of your repair. Continue to remove the release liner, pressing the tape into the surface. Use a hand roller to thoroughly embed the adhesive into the roof surface, ensuring proper adhesion. The next step is to apply roof extender number 981 sealant approximately 1/8 inch thick over the fleece back repair tape. The sealant should extend a minimum of 2 to 4 inches past the repair in all directions. Note, this will vary depending on specific application or penetration. Next, measure and cut a piece of 483 reinforcing fabric and embed it into the first layer of sealant. Starting at one end, brush the fabric into the sealant, eliminating all blisters, buckles, and fish mouths. The fabric should be completely embedded into the wet sealant and should form a smooth layer. Lastly, apply a second coat of roof extender number 981 on top of the fabric, sandwiching the fabric in the middle. Your detail is now complete and you can be assured of top quality and lasting performance.